Hi there, my name is Callie Chappelle, and welcome to this video about R Markdown. This video is made for Bio 47, which is Introduction to Research in Ecology and Evolutionary Biology. However, a lot of the slides were modified from Stats 32, which I actually took in fall of 2017, which was taught by Kenneth Tay. So a lot of the slides are based on slides that Kenneth presented. However, the code that I'll be showing you in a little bit, I wrote myself. So there's two different ways to save R code. You've been familiar with R scripts, which are essentially these files that contain R code that's meant to be run together. These are working files, so they're not meant to like show people necessarily. And you can comment directly into the code using the hashtag. And so you can recognize an R script because the file extension is .r. Now what I'll be telling you about today are R Markdown files. And these are kind of a special document format that weave together text, code, and output all into one file and are usually used for presentation of code. So you can have both the code and the results in one place by what we call knitting it into either a PDF or an HTML file. And you can recognize an R Markdown file because the file extension is r.rmd. So while in an R script, you might see something like this, where you've got lines of code and you've got these comments, an R Markdown file looks much more complex, where you have this header at the top, pretty much everything is just seen as text, and then what you have are these things called chunks, which are in between these kind of dot, dot, dots, and they have the code inside of them, and you can run the chunks individually, or you can run them all at once. Now, what is Markdown? So Markdown is a formatting that essentially converts text documents that have things like little hashtags and like little signs into this like really nice web file with styling. And so if I go to this website, Dillinger, which is really nice, you can actually kind of test out what something in Markdown would actually look like in HTML. So like, for example, this has like two hashtags and it was like a big header, and when I add more, you can see it gets smaller. I can make things like bolded by changing, by like, for example, putting asterisks around things. So you can kind of mess around with this, but this is just a website to show you how you can go from kind of this language or like this denotation to something that actually like looks like this in HTML. And so now I want to actually dive into R Markdown in R Studio. So I'm going to tell you how to make an R Markdown file, how to orient yourself, like how an R Markdown file works, how to knit an R Markdown file, and then how to kind of, I'll show you what the code looks like versus the HTML output after you knit it. So those words might not mean a lot to you right now, and that is A-okay. So I am in the Bio 47 data folder that you should have downloaded. So you can see I have it stored on my computer right here. And you'll see we're in 2020. So this is actually the most up-to-date version that was updated a couple days ago by Dr. Miller. And I've got my Bio 47 data R project here. So I'm actually going to open that R project. So you can see R Studio is opening. It's opening that R project. And this won't look like this for you because you won't have all this stuff up, but in the R project, here we go, I have an R Markdown file, this called demo R Markdown file. So I'm just gonna click on that. I'll send that to you later. That'll be available online and you'll just wanna download it and put it into your Bio 47 data folder. Now, one thing to note, I've already made this R Markdown file, and you can follow along with everything that I'm going to do in this demo today, but you might want to make your own R Markdown file. So that's really straightforward. You just go to File, New File, and then R Markdown. Then you can give it a title, so I'm just going to write test here. Default output format, I'd recommend HTML. Sometimes PDFs look a little bit silly, and so what you get is something that looks a little bit like this. Now I'm gonna show you kind of how R Markdown works in my demo file, but we'll come back to this in a second. So in my demo file, you can see I've got a title, demo R Markdown Bio 47. And the one I just made, you can see that I wrote in that like little pop-up window that came up that I wanted to be called test, and you can see it's test here, and it'll auto-generate the author that's based on your R profile, the today's date, and then what you want the output to be, HTML document. As I said, you can also output PDFs, but HTML documents are actually like much nicer. They end up looking a lot nicer. And the reason is because the output sometimes is like different sizes, and it looks just much nicer on like a in the browser than it does on a PDF, because it'll like kind of mess up some of your plots, but I'll explain what that means later. Then there's this. So like I said, this is called the chunk. I know it's kind of a funny R term, but essentially a chunk is just a little cookie here that it's not really a cookie in the computer science sense, but it's just like a little piece here that has your code inside of it. So this one you don't want to delete because this is what sets up the R markdown file. So we'll just ignore that. So what I want to do now is show you what this means. So the hashtag, like I said, in Markdown language means that this is header. So this is going to give me a header introduction. And then you can see there's all this text here. So if this was just regular, if this was a regular R script, all of this stuff, it would be like giving me all these errors, right? Because it's like trying to run this and it's just a sentence. So everything in R Markdown that's not inside of a chunk is considered to be text. So that makes it really nice to write a lot of notes about everything that you're doing. So I just said, this is a demo of R Markdown covering the tidyverse, which I'll go over in the next video, Basics for Bio 47. It was created by me in May of 2020. And so the first thing you can do is just orient yourself. So as you can see, I wrote, everything is considered text unless inside of a chunk. So it looks like this. Now I can run individual chunks by clicking on these little go buttons. And I can run multiple chunks by going up to run and then either run current chunk, run all chunks above, all below. I'll do all chunks above. So it's gonna run these two. And you can see that if I ran summary cars in the console, I would get this output, right? So summary cars, and then this is the output. But it also puts the output right below the chunk. So you can see in the actual document what the output is right next to the code, and you're not constantly trying to scroll between the console and this window up here. So like I said, you just press the go button and you can run multiple chunks by going up to run and then run current chunks. So this is just kind of the basics for R Markdown. Now getting back to the default, it gives you a couple of notes about R Markdown, so it reminds you that you can make a header, says this is an R Markdown file. For more details, you can go to this link. You can paste links into Markdown language by putting them inside of the greater than less than signs. And if you click knit, it will create a document that has the output as well. So like, again, I can run this chunk again. I can run this chunk, summary cars. I can include plots. So what you'll see is this makes a plot. And you can see that up here it says R cards. And this one says R pressure and then echo false. Echo false means that it's not going to show you the code. It's just going to show you the final plot. So if you want to like make a really nice file and you've got a ton of code and you like are like the person who I want to eventually show this to doesn't need to see all this code in the HTML, in the knitted HTML file, then you can just do that. Now, what does it mean to knit? So what I can do is click knit here. And it'll ask where I want to save it. I'll just put it in downloads for right now because we don't need to do that. We don't need to actually save that in my folder. So I can just write that. And then what you'll see is it creates this HTML file. And I can even hit open in browser and it'll actually open it in my Chrome browser. You can't see it right now. It'll actually open it in my Chrome browser. Let's see here. Here we go. Just like that. So as you could see, I'm just going to compare the R Markdown file and this side by side. So you can see that it created a title test. It has my name, it has the date, just like I said. It did create an HTML output. This is our setup include false. So the include false says that you're not gonna see this chunk in my markdown file. Indeed, we've got the two hashtags and we've got our header. This is a markdown document. This is everything that you can see here is written here. We've got this chunk summary cars. So you can see inside of this, this is how it like visually shows the chunk. It shows the code. And then right below it, it shows the output of that line of code. And then it says you can also embed plots. So we can see we've got including plots as a header. You can also embed plots, for example. And then there was this code, but you don't see it here because it says echo false. It just shows the output, right? And then it says, note that the echo false parameter was added to the code chunk to prevent printing of the R code that generated the plot. And that's exactly right. So I just wanted to show you this very simple R Markdown file. And just to show you a slightly more complicated one, I could knit this whole file. And you can see it's actually running all the chunks just like this. So they're all running. And when they're done, it will give me an HTML file, and here we go. Here it is. So orient to R Markdown. I just like to show this I'm just going to write open in browser so we can see this again. So if I just want to compare these side by side, right? Demo R Markdown, Bio 47, my name, today's date, the date that it was created, introduction, these are my notes, right? Orienting to R Markdown, here we go. Setting up, and then a couple of notes about setting up here. And then you can see there's code, there's the output, code, output, my notes here, just like that. And I'm going to be going through all of this in the next video, because this is my introduction to dplyr as well as my introduction to ggplot. So I hope that this was a useful video getting you oriented to using R Markdown. And in the next two videos, I'll be talking about using the tidyverse to use kind of a more updated version of the R programming language.